The OG colorways of the Jordan 4s might be the strongest OG lineup of all Jordan shoes. Now, don't quote me on it because I haven't actually thought too deeply about it, but like the black and red colorway, the white cement, the military blues, the fire reds, come on, you can't really beat that. You might be able to like be on that level, but you can't beat it. It's so nice. And the shoe I'm reviewing today, you can see a lot of the DNA from OG colorways make its way onto the shoe. And like I say about every Jordan 4, it's just really, really hard to make an ugly Jordan 4. You like really have to try to make a bad Jordan 4. This one, not as good as the OGs, but for me, I still really like it. Air Jordan 4 Red Cement. Now this shoe is dropping on September 9th for $210, and the Jordan 4 was actually the first Jordan shoe to have a global release, and the Jordan 4 Bred was the first Jordan shoe to introduce the world to Nubuck on a sneaker, so a lot of milestones reached for this shoe. Another fun fact, when the Jordan 4 retroed in 1999, so 10 years after the original release date in 89, they actually brought it back to be the exact same price. $100 in 89, $100 in 99, didn't take into account inflation. What a time to be alive. Now this is $210. 10 years from now, this is probably going to be $300. I can see that happening. And the official colors listed on the box for this shoe is white, fire red, and black. Makes sense. Obviously, they took the splatter pattern from the white cement, replaced the cement gray with fire red on this shoe. Just did a bit of a swap, just to combine a few different elements of OG colorways. And here it is. Here's the result. And I will have to say, maybe I'll get used to it, but I think as nice as the red is, as nice as this fire red is, maybe a bit too much. But then I look at it again, I just keep flip-flopping. It just grows on me, so can't make up my mind. I flip-flop between thinking it's a bit too much, thinking it's the right amount. Regardless, small detail, I still like the colorway of the shoe. Like I said, very, very hard to make an ugly Jordan 4. And the upper sole of the shoe is a white leather base layer. And the leather is pretty nice. It's nothing crazy, it's nothing premium, definitely not trash. It's pretty good. It's not like tumbled leather, but you can see the natural grains of the leather throughout. I like the leather on the shoe. And of course, this being a Jordan 4, it has one of the most distinct features of the Jordan 4 in the form of those wings that you see in that fire red color. That is linked to the lacing system, and that is to provide different lacing setups depending on the fit and preferences of your feet. And there's a lot of ventilation for the Jordan 4s because of that netting. And actually on the Jordan 4 Craft, it's just blocked off with suede. And on the booty of the Jordan 4, the heel tab comes in this soft kind of rubber TPU material. Now on the Jordan 4 SB Pine Green, it came in a much softer or springy heel tab. This one feels like other Jordan 4s, so it's got some give to it, but it's a bit more solid than the ones on the Pine Green. And a Jordan Jumpman on the booty instead of Nike Air. This not being an OG colorway, doesn't come with a Nike Air on the back of the shoe. Sometimes they'll break that rule, like on the upcoming Armour Manier Jordan 5 Diffuse Blue colorway. I believe that shoe actually has Nike Air on the booty, even though it's not an OG colorway. But most of the time, if you see the Jordan Jumpman on the back of the shoe for a Jordan 4, it's not an OG colorway. Another place you'll see the Jumpman is on the tongue, in the same fire red color with the very classic Flight logo underneath. The Flight logo and concept was actually first introduced on the Jordan 4, and on the inside of the tongue, you'll see an upside down Jordan tag. And if you didn't know, again, back in the late 80s, early 90s, exactly what time, I'm not sure, but people would wear their tongues like flipped outside. So Jordan brand anticipating it, they would make the tag on the inside of their tongue upside down. So when people flipped it out, it would be the right side up. The Jordan 4 does come with a polyurethane midsole, obviously with a visible Nike Air unit on the heel. Also has a Nike Air unit on the forefoot. And the rubber outsole of the shoe is predominantly herringbone, apart from that cutout in the middle with the Jumpman. Really, really like the outsole of the Jordan 4. I think it's one of the best ever. And because of the herringbone traction, I still think it holds up today. Now, this shoe doesn't come with any extra laces because $210 is not enough for them to give you a set of extra laces. But in all seriousness, if I had to choose a color, maybe black. But I think the white laces look perfect on the shoe. It just, yeah, can't really go wrong like this. Box of the shoe, a pretty standard Jordan 4 Flight Jumpman box with the red Jumpman in the middle and the Flight logo across. Very standard, nothing too special. Now moving on to size and comfort, I'm a size 9.5 true to size. I do have wide feet. The Jordan 4 is one of those shoes for us wide footers. there's just no perfect fit. I do go up half a size in the Jordan 4 because the Jordan 4 toe box is pretty notorious for being narrow on wide footers, especially that pinky area. It really kills my feet if I go true to size for Jordan 4. But when I move up half a size, lengthwise, especially around the ankle collar in terms of like the looseness, it's not the best. In terms of cushioning, it is a very old shoe. It's more of that flatter or more solid and stiff feeling shoe. I don't mind that too much, especially with the ankle collar padding around the shoe. Always very nice. The padding on the tongue is super nice as well. So I like that. But overall, the Jordan 4, it's a bit stiff. It's just not the most comfortable shoe in a vacuum. So I do recommend, if you don't have wide feet, stick true to size. If you do, strongly consider going up half a size. And that brings the total sole score to 16 out of 25. Pretty average score compared to other general releases. Now, in terms of colorway, I think this is a very, very nice colorway. A predominantly white sneaker on a Jordan 4. You've already kind of won 90% of people's hearts. The amount of red on the shoe may be a bit too much. However, in a vacuum, I think it's still a very nice colorway. Super wearable, super simple. Yeah, there's not much to say about it. In terms of materials, I think the leather is nice. Nothing crazy, nothing premium. Has a polyurethane midsole, so at least it's kind of lighter than like a rubber cup sole that you see on the Jordan 1s. But overall, the materials of this Jordan 4, not the greatest, but definitely still nice. In terms of comfort, like I alluded to earlier, for people with wide feet, this is not going to be the most comfortable shoe. Even if you don't have wide feet, it's still a pretty stiff shoe. The cushioning, if you prefer a softer feel, this is probably not the shoe for you. It's just pretty stiff. In terms of versatility, a white Jordan 4 sneaker, how can you go wrong? This is so versatile. Jordan 4, probably one of the more versatile sneakers after the Jordan 1 or 3, maybe on the same level, maybe more for some people. Well, however you order it, it's one of the most versatile sneakers that's ever been made, and it holds up in 2023. In terms of the versatility of the colorway, again, predominantly white, can wear it with anything, red and black, versatility, winning. Storytelling wise, it's a general release, not much of a story to tell. As I said in the intro of my video, it is like impossible to make an ugly Jordan 4. All the Jordan 4s that come out, even if you don't love it, you see them in hand, you look at it, it's just like, it's nice. I may not love it, but I can't really say I dislike it. And it's the same with this shoe. Don't love it, it's hard not to compare it to the OG colorways, but in a vacuum, just looking at it, I think it's a very wearable shoe, very nice looking shoe, and it's a Jordan 4. Not much to say. So that's it. Thanks for watching, Sole Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 4 Red Cement. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.